Hi guys, I'm the face and voice behind this particular channel, and it makes me really happy when I read all those wonderful comments from you guys. I have a small request. If you have not subscribed to my channel already, please go ahead and do it now. And I have another request. I'm working on this new initiative, a new YouTube channel named An Indian Abroad. It will be really helpful if you go ahead and subscribe to that channel, and I assure you that you will get wonderful content from that channel as well.
Hi guys, my name is Vivek, and in this video tutorial we are going to talk about reverse key index. Guys, I have a quick request. If you have not subscribed to my channel already, please go ahead and do it now so that you get a notification as soon as I upload a new tutorial. In this video tutorial, we are going to talk about reverse key Btree index, how they are different from the traditional Btree index, in what case we should use reverse key index, what is the problem that they solve, and what is the challenge associated with reverse key index. The basic idea behind the reverse Btree index is to improve the performance of DML operations. We all know that index can significantly improve the performance in case of select queries, but there is a cost associated with index. Every time we perform an insert, update or delete operation on the table, Oracle has to update the index as well. It has to maintain that index. And that index maintenance can get really acute in certain scenarios, and we will see in a moment what that scenario is. But the basic idea behind reverse Btree index is to avoid index block contention and to improve the data load performance or data update performance. Now, in which case we should go ahead and create reverse Btree index? When we have a column in a table that is being populated with numerically increasing value, for example, order ID in order table or transaction ID in transaction table, if I am populating these columns, the next row will have higher order ID or higher transaction ID than the previous row. Possibly I am populating these values using an Oracle sequence, or if I am using Informatica, possibly I am using sequence generator to populate this value. Now let's move on to our next slide to see what is the challenge associated with this kind of column. If we go ahead and create a normal Btree index, what exactly will be the challenge? So this is how a normal Btree index looks like. We have three leaf blocks and one branch block. Now the challenge is, as I mentioned, the next row that is going to get inserted will have higher order ID than the previous row. That means every time a new row is inserted into the order table, Oracle, in order to maintain the index, will go ahead and try to update this particular block. Now guys, imagine if you are working for a retail organization where you are processing millions of orders on a daily basis. That means at a particular instance, 500 orders are being placed, and all those 500 orders will go ahead and try to update this particular rightmost block. And guys, this will lead to index block contention, and you will have all type of waits. You will have buffer busy wait, you will have read by other session. So guys, there is a good chance that if there are certain orders that are being updated or deleted, they are one of the more recent orders, they will be more prone to updation or deletion. So we can have a read by other session wait, and since we are inserting so many rows to a particular index block, we will have index splitting very often. So we will have index block split wait as well. And guys, mark my word on this particular thing. If you have a table that is being populated by multiple sessions on a frequent basis, and you have a column like order ID, which has numerically increasing values, if you go ahead and create a normal Btree index, you will have performance hit while inserting the data, because multiple sessions will go ahead and try to insert that data, and they will try to update the same index block. And this problem actually gets very acute when we are dealing with Oracle RSC environment, because multiple sessions on different node are trying to get hang of this particular rightmost leaf block, which actually results in slow performance, because we have all these kind of wait, buffer busy wait, index block split wait, and read by other session wait. Now I have defined the problem statement. What exactly is the solution for that? The solution for that is reverse key index. Now this is normally how the data is stored in case of a Btree index. The storage is slightly different when it comes to reverse Btree index. Let's see how the data is stored in case of reverse Btree index. In that case, Oracle reverses the key. For example, 300 will be stored as 103 and 302 will be stored as 203. So now instead of inserting the data on the rightmost block for every new value, the values will be actually distributed in different leaf blocks, which will reduce the index block contention. I mean, for this particular use case, it sounds like a great idea. You have a numerically increasing values, which was leading to index block contention. You created a reverse key index, because of which the data was distributed in different leaf blocks. So for example, now that we are representing 301 as 103 and 302 as 203, in this particular case, 103 will be stored in this particular leaf block, while 203 will be stored in this particular leaf block, and so on. So instead of inserting the data in our rightmost leaf block, we have reduced that particular contention, and now the data is being distributed almost normally on my leaf blocks. So that is the prime purpose of reverse key index. It is basically used to reduce the index block contention. One more important thing I want to tell you here is, though I have mentioned that 301 will be stored as 103 and 302 will be stored as 203, that is not exactly how Oracle works. Oracle actually stores the data in hexadecimal. So for example, if I'm trying to store order ID 20, instead of storing it directly as 20, Oracle will store it as C1,15. And in case of reverse key index, it's going to reverse these two bytes and it's going to store 15,7. So you can see the hexadecimal value using this particular query. Select raw to hex 20 from dual, you will get this particular value, C1,15. Now in this particular case, guys, reverse key index was very helpful. It actually reduced our index block contention to a great extent. And to be honest, if you have a table like this in an Oracle RSC environment, you will definitely want to create a reverse key index. You don't want the load performance to be significantly low, but there is a challenge associated with reverse key index. And the challenge is that since the index is not organized sequentially, we cannot perform index range scan on reverse key index. So in majority of the cases, guys, there is a challenge that if you want to retrieve the data between two IDs, for example, if you want to retrieve the data between ID 200 and 300, instead of doing an index range scan, which it would have done in the case of a normal Btree index, if you have created a reverse Btree index, that index range scan is no more possible. It will not allow you to do that. So that is one challenge when it comes to reverse Btree index. Though it improves your DML performance when it comes to insert, update and delete, at the same time there is a restriction that in majority of the cases you cannot go ahead and perform index range scan. And I will give you a quick tip when we switch to our SQL developer and I demonstrate how this works, that although between or greater than or less than cannot work, if you have created a reverse Btree index, you should use between clause, and we will see why. So guys, just to do a quick recap, in which particular case you should go ahead and create reverse Btree index: if you have a column in a table that has numerically increasing value, for example, order ID in order table or transaction ID in transaction table, if you are expecting way too many inserts on a regular basis, and that too in an Oracle RSC environment, that can lead to index block contention on the rightmost block, which can actually lead to serious performance issues. In that case, what you can do is you can go ahead and create a reverse key index, which will actually reverse the digits. For example, 301 will be stored as 103, 302 will be stored as 203. That means the data will be distributed uniformly in different leaf blocks, which will reduce the index block contention. Now this has a downside as well. Since we are not sequentially storing the data in our Btree index, we cannot do index range scan, and I will show that in a moment how that works when we switch to our SQL developer. So guys, here I'm creating a table, reverse index demo. It has two columns, order ID and product. Table has been created. Now I'm going to go ahead and insert 1000 rows in this particular table. the data has been inserted. Now what I'll do is I will go ahead and create a unique Btree index. I've committed the reverse sign, so it's a normal index. I will go ahead and create this unique index. Now as I mentioned, I will run this particular query where I will fetch the details of order ID between 10 and 20. So if I go ahead and run it, it will give me 10 rows. If I go ahead and run the explain plan for this, since I have used a normal Btree index, when I see the explain plan, I will see that the Oracle has done an index range scan. So if you see here, the Oracle has done an index range scan and then it's fetching the data from the table using table access by index row ID. Furthermore, if I go ahead and select a particular ID, order ID 10, since I've created a unique index, it should do an index unique scan. So let's go ahead and verify that. So if you see here, it did an index unique scan. So if I try to run this particular query where I'm getting the details corresponding to order ID 20 and 20, if I run the explain plan for that, I will see that it will do an index unique scan, and on top of that, it will do a inlist iterator. So first it did an index unique scan and then it did an inlist iterator. Now let's go ahead and create a reverse Btree index. The challenge with this particular scenario, as I've explained, is this particular reverse index demo table is being updated by multiple sessions. So we have index block contention if I've created a normal index. So if I try to insert multiple rows from 10 different sessions, I will see that the performance is pretty low. So let me go ahead and drop this particular table. So the table has been dropped. I will quickly recreate this particular table. Now this time I will create an index, but I will create a reverse key index. So the syntax for reverse key index is pretty similar to the normal Btree index. You have to add the reverse keyword in the end. So I've added the reverse keyword in the end. I will go ahead and create the unique index. So here a reverse Btree index has been created, guys. And as I've mentioned that this reverse Btree index will solve my index contention problem. So if multiple sessions are trying to add data into my reverse index demo table, my load performance will still be relatively fast, but at the same time I will have to compromise my index range scan will not work. So if I go ahead and execute this particular query, earlier when I had a normal Btree index, the index was being used. But right now what I'm saying is, since I've created a reverse Btree index, that will not be used in this particular case where I'm doing a between clause, a range clause, where ideally it should have done an index range scan. That will not be done. Instead, it will go ahead and do a table access full. So let's see that. So if you see here, it did a table access full. Instead of using that particular index, it did not use that index. Similarly, if I go ahead and specify order ID greater than 200, again it will not do an index range scan. It will do a table access full because my index is not sequentially organized, so it doesn't have that capability. It did a table access full. This particular query will function as it was functioning for a normal Btree index. So here where I've specified equals to predicate, if I go ahead and run the explain plan for this particular query, I will see that it will do an index unique scan. So if you see here, it did an index unique scan and then the data was fetched using table access by index row ID. Now guys, this is one important thing that I want to tell you. Since we saw that index range scan is not possible when we have a reverse Btree index, so if you know the number of values that you want to fetch, you want to use in clause. For example, here if I want to add another value 10, 20 and 30, if I go ahead and run this particular query, what Oracle will do, it will do an index unique scan and then it will use the inlist iterator to retrieve that particular data. So here I just wanted to select three values. Instead of doing a full table scan, it did an index unique scan, then it accessed those particular value and it did an inlist iteration. So whenever you are creating a reverse Btree index, in that case, while you are solving index block contention problem, you have this drawback that you cannot do an index rain scan. Now, this is up to your project requirement. What exactly do you want? You have to evaluate whether you're going to do frequent range-based queries or whether data load is also of vital importance to that. You have to consider that in your mind when you are creating the index. But yes, if you have to do certain range-related query, you can still go ahead and use in clause. Then it will go ahead and do index unique scan, and further it will use inlist iteration to give the values. So hopefully guys, after this, it is clear why we use reverse Btree index, what is its utility and what are the challenges associated with this. Thanks a lot guys for watching this particular video, and I'll see you in the next one.